Hi, I'm John Reed, amateur astronomer and author of the 50 Things to See with a Telescope book series. This is the last of three videos showcasing the many observing programs that the RASC has to offer. In this third video, we'll look at the two advanced level observing programs, David Levy's Deep Sky Gems and Deep Sky Challenge Objects. The RASC will issue a certificate to any RASC member who completes either of these programs. Before you attempt the advanced programs, it is recommended that you complete both the Messier Catalog Observing Program and the Finest NGC Objects Program. The first advanced program is David Levy's Deep Sky Gems. David Levy is a Canadian amateur astronomer and RASC member who discovered over 22 comets by viewing and photographing the night sky. With over four decades of comet hunting, Levy created a list of 400 deep sky objects that he came across. The Deep Sky Gems Observing Program includes 154 unique objects not included in any other RASC observing program. This list is published in the annual RASC Observer's Handbook. Most of the objects in this list are galaxies and star clusters. To complete this observing program, you will need a telescope of at least 12 inches of aperture, and a dark sky observing site. You may also need deep sky filters to enhance low contrast objects. When you're finished, present your logbook to your local RASC center for validation, and they will issue your certificate. The second advanced program is the Deep Sky Challenge Objects. RASC members Alan Dyer and Alistair Ling are experienced observers and created this challenge list of 45 deep sky objects that will push your observing skills to the limit. The list is published in the RASC Observer's Handbook. Most of these are galaxies and gaseous nebulae. There's even a couple of quasars. To complete this observing program, you need a dark sky observing site, a telescope of at least 12 inches in aperture, deep sky filters to increase the contrast, and remember, it's okay to borrow a friend's telescope if you need it. When you're finished, present your logbook to your local RASC center for validation, and they will issue your certificate. So that's it for the advanced level observing programs. Be sure to watch the other two videos in this series where I tell you about the beginner level and intermediate level observing programs that the RASC offers. And don't forget, the stars belong to everyone.